rescue, or destroy.
Love spiders.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This guy wears his sunglasses in the dark.
Rescue, or destroy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like heavy metal. Like, you know.
Oh, yeah. And I should have gone and grabbed a roll of tinfoil and wrapped it around my head.
Mm-hmm. Rescue, or destroy.
I like it. I like it a lot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Filter coffee shop.
Yes, exactly.
Sweet potato fries. They are the bomb.
Stuck in a riptide for a second. You're just kind of like trying to pull me down.
As I'm being like engulfed in a sweet potato fry, I'm trying
to swim. Remember to swim.
And the sauce.
Yes.
Delicious.
It's dealing with the fact of the fatty fluids and everything that it...
That's when those little moments come into your head and you think, swim, but don't swim like an idiot and don't kick your feet like you're going to be eaten by a shark.
And back to the fry.
It's that fear moment, though. That's the crucial part. And you use your head just a little bit. And next thing you know, I was free again. Painting backwards. Thinking everything backwards. I'm thinking in the negative concept. Tofu Reuben.
Arborescence means tree. And if it ends up branching out to where people really are engulfed into it, and they really want something to do with it at the same time as well, that's when you know that you're actually doing something. Damn, that is one crazy-ass bastard. And the guy with a nut job. I'm not someone that really wants to push forward on making myself as, like, that guy. I don't want to be walking into a room and everyone just being like, hey, here's a beer, here's a drink, here, everything's comped on me. You know, I like to be normal. That's my Southside factor right there. So, yeah, for us, it's very much so just like you work for what you get, you strive for what you want. Keep it simple, though. You don't need to be driving the fancy cars. You don't need to be having the beautiful wife. You don't even need a wife, you know? Just have a dog if you want, even, you know, and you're all good. Back to the passion. Rescue or destroy. That's what you need to come and see on April 3rd, 8 to 11 p.m. Come on up there, Gallery Bar. We're going to be breaking stuff. We're going to be living it up. We're going to be hopefully seeing some of you people rescue some of that work. Notches on the block, you know. See that it's made on this and this and this. Yeah. Everyone knows that. It's my own fault. Cutting block. Alan over here, who just comes up and just smashes the shit out of it. It releases that negative feeling, even that positive feeling, that happy feeling. It just puts it back out there again. It's that energy factor. It just goes right back out into the universe again. So just like starting to get them out, just start showing them. This whole show is a gift to you. Rescue or Destroy, April 3rd. Come on out to Gallery Bar from 8 to 11 o'clock. Rescue some art, find something that you love, and
celebrate my birthday.
Celebrate Alan's birthday at the same time. That is right. This big bear is getting older and older over here. I was surprised when that last piece that I put in ended up selling when David Leonardis bought it. That piece was supposed to get chopped to pieces. I wanted to reuse it, David. That was supposed to go somewhere else. That was supposed to be a new project, and you decided to frame it and hang it. Love you for it, but at the same time, chop it. Give it back to me. We'll see if Alan actually chops up the Buddha. That's going to be an interesting thing right there.
I'm going to send it to Nirvana.
Exactly.
I'm going to send Buddha to Nirvana.
Alan will be sending Buddha to Nirvana on April 3rd if you don't come out and rescue.
And we're live.
Back behind you, the three-part paneling here on these windows. It starts from the evolution. You light on fire. You burn towards the inside. Finally, you're finished. Right at the end. That's the story of life right there. You're always on fire while you're alive. You finally fizzle out, and then you're done. People with the minds, people with the minds, people with the mind. You got Mr. Kerouac, one of the gods. Pain or love or danger will make you real again. Good old Chicago, how many times have you been on that blue line? When you're sitting there, you're like, what is that funk? What is that funk? It smells like a goddamn camel right now, doesn't it? They go right through the floor on you, right through the floor. Good old Chicago.
Do you know what nemesis means? A righteous infliction of retribution manifested by an appropriate agent. Personified in this case by a horrible cunt. Me.
We're putting it out there for you. Bringing it to you. Come and get it. Come and get it. April 3rd, Gallery Bar, 8 to 11 p.m.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm.